Hello everyone, I am Dr. Yogesh Pawde. I welcome you to the next session in this lecture series on genetics and molecular biology. Up to this session, we have covered DNA replication, DNA repair, transcription and post-transcriptional modifications. Today we are going to discuss about reverse transcription. Reverse transcription is the transcription process which is exactly opposite of DNA transcription. To study that, the Temin and Baltimore have isolated reverse transcripted enzyme in 1970. They studied it and they were awarded the Nobel Prize for their extensive study in this reverse transcription area under and genetics and molecular biology. So let us see what is the utility of reverse transcriptase enzyme. Reverse transcriptase, as the name suggests, it is used by retroviruses to replicate their genomes. Okay, these are RNA viruses, and the reverse transcriptase enzyme synthesizes DNA using their RNA as a template and synthesizing DNA so that the DNA can be incorporated into host cell genome and then they can produce the viral proteins. Okay, apart from that, there are various retrotransposons also, which are usually the mobile genetic elements to proliferate within the host genome. So transposons, we know these are jumping genes. There are retrotransposons also, which utilizes reverse transcriptase enzyme to synthesize DNA, and they function as mobile genetic elements. The eukaryotic cells also utilize reverse transcriptase enzyme to extend the telomeres at the ends of their linear chromosomes. Some non-retroviruses such as hepatitis B virus also utilize reverse transcriptase for their replication. These are actually the double-stranded DNA retroviral viruses belonging to the family of hepatitis. And in recombinant DNA technology and genetic engineering, the reverse transcriptase enzyme is utilized to generate complementary DNA from an RNA template. And various molecular biology techniques like molecular cloning, RNA sequencing, then polymerase chain reaction, and genome analysis is also done based on reverse transcriptase enzyme. The reverse transcripted enzyme has three sequential biochemical activities. This enzyme is all-rounder enzyme which has three activities, so it does not require any other enzyme for the complete reverse transcription process except the S1 nuclease. Okay, so what are the three sequential biochemical properties or activities this retroviral reverse transcriptase has? It has RNA dependent DNA polymerase. So based on the RNA which is there as a genome in retroviruses, the DNA will be synthesized. It requires RNA dependent DNA polymerase activity. Then there is ribonuclease H activity. So after the DNA is synthesized, RNA will be destroyed by ribonuclease H activity of retroviral reverse transcriptase. Then a DNA template will be available, and to replicate that, the DNA dependent DNA polymerase activity will be required. So all these three activities are present in the single enzyme, that is reverse transcriptase, and that is present in retroviruses. Let us understand the technique of converting RNA transcripts into complementary DNA, which is utilized as a part of genetic engineering. So, coming to the steps of conversion of RNA transcripts to complementary DNA. First of all, we obtain mRNA from red blood cell precursors. These red blood cell precursors will be utilized to get mRNA so that we get a RNA transcript. We get mRNA from the RBC cytoplasm and we purify. So, after the purification, we will get the pure mRNA templates. Okay, and those mRNA templates will be exposed to reverse transcriptase enzyme. So the addition of reverse transcriptase, the required 4 deoxyribonucleotides and the primers at optimum temperature, the mixture will be exposed to the mRNA templates. Using the mRNA as a template for transcription, the single strand complementary DNA is synthesized. This can be explained based on this image. You can see there are poly A ribonucleotides at 3 prime end. Transcription by RNA transcriptase enzyme will start from 5 prime end to 3 prime end. The RNA transcriptase enzyme will move from 3 prime end to 5 prime end. The initial oligo A ribonucleotides will be paired with oligo DT sequences. Okay, so these are deoxythymidine, and this deoxythymidine will pair with adenosines, which are ribonucleotides on mRNA template. This process will generate single-strand complementary DNA, which will be bound to mRNA template. So there will be a hybrid complementary DNA to mRNA. Okay. And this will be synthesized by reverse transcriptase enzyme, and which activity of that reverse transcriptase, that will be the RNA dependent DNA polymerase. So based on RNA, that is complementary DNA, is synthesized. Then coming to the next step, the primers used are actually the oligo DT, that is oligo deoxythymidine primer. And the primers, because the initial sequence is oligo A on mRNA template, the primer is going to be oligo DT, so as to initiate the polymerization of first complementary DNA strand. This is the first complementary DNA strand in the process of reverse transcription, and it will start from 3' end of all mRNAs which are there in the mixture. Then coming to the next step, after synthesis of first single strand complementary DNA is finished, the mRNA complementary DNA hybrids are denatured into single strands by heating the hybrids to higher temperature. So now we want to get rid of the mRNA templates which were used to synthesize complementary DNA. But for its denaturation or destroying the mRNA, we need to separate the complementary DNA and mRNA. So for that, we have to separate by increasing the temperature so that the annealing the bonding between the complementary DNA nucleotides and mRNA nucleotides will be broken down. Both complementary DNA and mRNA will be separated. Then in the next step, RNase H enzyme, or the RNase H activity of reverse transcriptase enzyme, will digest the original RNA strands, original mRNA strands, and it will leave intact single-stranded complementary DNA. Right? Then coming to the next step, now we have only DNA in the mixture or in the medium. Now this complementary DNA will be utilized to replicate DNA or to multiply this DNA. So how to do that? We need primers also. Complementary DNA will fold on themselves at their 3' end, like this, like a hook. Okay, and they will form a transient hairpin loops that serve as primers for the synthesis of second DNA strand. The complementary DNA, by folding at its 3' end like a hairpin loop, will serve as a primer for its replication, so as to produce second DNA strand from the first one. The next step, the first complementary DNA strand acts as a template for the synthesis of the second complementary DNA strand. And the DNA dependent DNA polymerase activity will be utilized for replication of second complementary DNA from the first complementary DNA. And for that, it will require deoxyribonucleotides. It will initiate the synthesis of second complementary DNA strand from the first strand. The products are double-stranded complementary DNA molecules. So this is the product which will have two strands of complementary DNA. The S1 nucleus has to cleave this hairpin loop so that a properly organized double helix of the complementary DNA can be synthesized. So for that, the hairpin loop which have acted as a primer needs to be removed, and for that S1 nucleus enzyme will be utilized. This complementary DNA will be used to insert into a vector for cloning process. Now let us understand few more facts regarding reverse transcription process. Some fragments from the RNA digestion. You understand that we have destroyed the RNA with the help of RNase H activity of reverse transcriptase enzyme. The fragments from RNA digestion can also serve as the primer for the DNA polymerase. So there may not be need to form hairpin loops at the 3' end of the complementary DNA, because RNA fragments are there which can be utilized as a primer for DNA replication. These are responsible for making the other plus strand. The self-replicating stretches of eukaryotic genome, like transposons, here there are retrotransposons. We utilize reverse transcriptase to move from one position in the genome to another via an RNA intermediate. and they are mostly found in genomes of plants and animals. Then the most important thing of reverse transcription is the telomerase and its relation with reverse transcription process. The telomerase is a reverse transcriptase enzyme. It is found in many eukaryotes, including humans. You know the significance of telomerase? It is related with aging process. And it carries its own RNA template for DNA replication. It will have its own provision for DNA replication because it needs to save the length of the DNA. It uses a short RNA strand. The sequence to be mentioned precisely is 5' C-U-A-A-C-C-C-U-A-A-C up to 3' end as a template. And when the DNA will be synthesized from this particular sequences, it will be having TTAGGG repeat sequences at the end of the chromosomes. And telomeres are nothing but the repeat sequences of TTAGGG. Those sequences are replenished in telomeres of DNA. It will ensure the longevity of the DNA molecule. So for that, what is required is reverse transcription process and the reverse transcriptase activity by the telomerase enzyme. It lengthens the telomere structures and the age of the DNA molecule also is lengthened. Okay, and this was regarding the reverse transcription process. We have discussed about reverse transcriptase enzyme. We have discussed few important factors regarding reverse transcription, and we discussed the genetic engineering technique to convert RNA transcripts into complementary DNA so that it can be utilized in cloning process through a vector. This was regarding reverse transcription, and this is literature which you can also go through for your deeper studies. Thank you so much for watching the video. Hope you have all subscribed to the channel, and if you are not, kindly subscribe to the channel so as to get notifications in future also for the upcoming videos. Thank you very much. Keep watching, keep learning, and keep motivating us.